Acacia is a Korean horror movie that definitely surprised me. Going into the movie, I hadn't heard a lot about the director, the actors, or even negative or positive praise. I hadn't heard very much at all. So when I ended up watching the movie, I was just surprised at how competent of a horror movie it ended up turning out to be. It wasn't going for any sort of shock value or scream out loud moments, but what the movie did have was definitely a combination of a pretty good, unique, interesting storyline with enough, you know, moments there that were creepy and put a shiver up your spine to end up making, you know, a horror movie experience that was a pretty good one. The movie revolves around a married couple that's been trying to conceive for a very long time, and with so many attempts at having a child just not work out, they eventually adopt a young boy, and things just get a little odd because this young boy seems to have an obsession with trees. He's drawing trees all the time, and he's also spending a lot of his time with the tree in the backyard, and there's already a little bit of a disconnect between him and his new parents because he spends so much time with the tree in the backyard. But not only that, the wife eventually does end up having a baby. She is able to conceive later on, and then that even creates more separation because there's a new child, but then they still have, you know, their adopted son. So this creates for a little bit of friction, and from there, you know, things get definitely hairy, and it's something I enjoyed very much. I really like how this story didn't develop itself as sort of like an omen or a reincarnation of the devil. Like, certainly it wasn't that this little boy was just one of those children that is always creepy. I mean, this little boy, what they developed horror out of was just the fact that his obsession was an odd one, the fact that he was always drawing and around the tree in the backyard constantly. It created horror from this aspect, rather than creating some sort of monster-like little boy or some sort of little boy that was a ghost. It didn't go for that at all. And I'm really glad that this movie didn't go for that storyline that's already done before, because just in terms of the pacing of the movie and the presentation of the story, I mean, I've seen its style done in a lot of Korean horror movies, but that's not really a negative because this movie does it very well. I mean, it reminds me a lot of Phone or Witchboard or even A Tale of Two Sisters. While not being as good, you know, as A Tale of Two Sisters, this movie definitely has that same sort of pacing and style that I've seen in a lot of really good Korean thriller movies. And as I said a little bit before, this movie is more comparable to something like Whispering Corridor's Memento Mori, where it has a good storyline with just a few, you know, elements of horror mixed in there. Because first and foremost, it's not, you know, really going to make you jump out of your seat. But it is one of those good storylines that towards the end of the movie, its climax really does get interesting. And, you know, with you paying attention to the movie, there is definitely a payoff for the audience that, you know, invests their time into the movie. What I can definitely say I've seen enough of, though, now in climaxes is that, you know, that thunderstorm, rainy weather. I mean, I don't think this movie needed to go for that sort of cliche, you know, extra bit there. I mean, I think the movies that develop that is just, it's extra drama to sort of add on top of these, you know, moments that the audience is shocked to find out, you know, what exactly is going on. And I didn't think that this movie needed it because its climax was very well done. But that's only a small little thing that I've just noticed a lot of films do. But I really like that by the time we got to the climax, by the time the film had, you know, gone over just, you know, an hour and a half now, and it was just ending, how it was able to, you know, sort of change my opinion about characters. Like, if a movie is able to make your opinion go from a character if you think they're good to bad, or change it in the reversal, you thought the character was bad, but then, you know, you end up liking them at the end. Like, when it's able to take you through those emotions, I think it's very well done, and I don't want to reveal too much about it, but my opinions of the characters changed, and the way their interactions changed, and I really like that quite a lot. Acacia was released on Region 1 DVD by Tartan Asia Extreme, and the release is definitely a good one, just because besides, you know, containing the movie itself, it does have some special features as well. The making of featurettes are broken up into a number of sections, and while they're not very long, you know, I did learn a few interesting things. I mean, I definitely did finally learn that the director was the same director who did Whispering Corridors, and he just talked a little bit about how he usually works with, you know, unexperienced young actors, a lot more often than he does, you know, experienced ones. And sometimes that, you know, is an advantage and a disadvantage. Even the director, you know, talked a little bit about how it was hard to show, you know, get those dramatic emotional scenes or, you know, exactly what he wanted from, you know, all that rain pouring in the background. So definitely a few of the special features. There's even a commentary on there. Definitely, you know, it's a good watch for people who enjoyed the movie.
So I think a lot of people will really end up enjoying this movie. While it's not for people who are looking for action-packed, you know, jump-out-of-your-seat scares, what it does do is develop, you know, a very good movie that's an excellent mix of thriller and horror. While it can compete with the very best horror movies that have come out of Korea, what it does do is it does develop the good pacing and, you know, style that we've come to expect from Korean, you know, thriller horror movies, and it does it so well that by the end, the audience, I'm pretty sure they're going to be satisfied with what they see, and it's maybe not one that you're going to come back to and watch, you know, all the time, but I think it's one you're going to remember as a solid movie, so I definitely recommend people should see it.